Carolina has never had a great deal of professional sports success. And this is what happens to the Buffaloes, or there's just certain NFL cities, certain NBA cities. If you don't have a ton of success in sports, Kansas City Chiefs, I mean, Len Dawson is still a legend in town. Carolina's had a lot of college success, the Tar Heels, Duke, but they haven't had much pro success. So Carolina gets really defensive when anybody criticizes Cam Newton. Like, Cam Newton has had 10 great games. Cam Newton, 7 years in, I don't like his self-awareness. I don't like his touch. I don't think he has a refined pocket presence. I don't think he's great pre-snap. I mean, I'm watching him yesterday against the Saints. The Saints are the team everybody gets healthy on. And, like, at some point, when can the Cam Newton fanboys and the Carolina media just be honest about this? He has had one great advantage that a lot of players don't have. He's had no chaos. One of the best owners. A solid B coach. He's had Mike Shula with him for years. Okay, there's a lot of chaos in this league. Jared Goff has one coach. Jared Goff has another. I mean, you see in the NFL, coordinators, revolving door, coordinator. Guy will walk in the NFL and have two head coaches in 4 years and three coordinators. Look what Andrew Luck has dealt with. Coaches, coordinators, impulsive owner, offensive line. Cam Newton, for most of his career, so one owner, one offensive coordinator, quarterback coach, one head coach, better than average defenses, and by and large has had a division of mostly average-funded, dysfunctional team. Tampa's been dysfunctional for most of the last 10 years. New Orleans the last half decade's been dysfunctional defensively. And Atlanta's now hot, but for years they were meh. Chris Carter on First Things First, you know, he was talking about, you know, kind of like Cam looks like he not only has an offensive coordinator, he's got a fashion coordinator, best-dressed guy in the league. I'm not sure if it's worth anything, but he was yesterday, and Chris Carter was critical of him.
Be self-aware. You lost. You got humiliated. Take off your damn hat, your sunglasses. You're doing an interview. Like, what did you do that would make you wear that to a press conference? Every week he has on a different outfit, a different hat, different glasses. That I wish that he would spend that much time reading coverages, finding out what cover two is, cover three is. Where can I put the ball? Where not take the ball? All right?
You know, it's interesting because, you know, guys can wear what they want to wear. But I had a multiple-time Pro Bowler tell me yesterday off the air when he saw Cam walk into the football stadium. His takeaway was, you know how much work that is?
They do have stylists.
He's like,
so he might not have to put that work into it.
But again, let's not pander. Like, his lack of self-awareness, he seems incredibly concerned about appearance. It's like, dude, you just had a horrible game. Like, in the end, we can keep defending and Carolina. 8 years in, man, this is what it is. It's a lot of style. He's more known more now for his celebration than his wins. That's what he's known for now. And by the way, it's an interesting. We were talking about this earlier, that Tom Brady's got a chip on his shoulder and Aaron Rodgers got a chip on his shoulder. And a lot of the great players in sports have a chip on their shoulder. I wonder psychologically. Cam was born with that. He's like, looks like a model. He's got the perfect smile. He was big, strong, fast, and it worked in high school, and it worked in college, and he won in junior college. Did Cam get so many gifts early? The look, the smile, the personality, the talent, the size, the arm, the athletic ability. I'm not saying he didn't work at it, but if you look at most of these quarterbacks who are great in this league, Drew Brees was told no by the University of Texas. Ohio State ignored Big Ben. Tom Brady dropped in the draft. So did Aaron Rodgers. Chip on the shoulder creates this lifelong work ethic. Cam got accolades and attention and love, and it worked in high school and college. And I look at his mechanics, and my thing about Cam is, if you love the game, any game, any sport, anything in life, if you love it, you put time into it. His mechanics, 7 years in, are still below average. Like, how can you do something for 7 years? You could be a mechanic. You could be a quarterback. You could be an accountant. You could be a dentist. If you're not paying attention to the details, do you love the job or do you love what the job provides you?
Can we put up that video of his outfit, though, one more time?
Yeah.
Because like I have a really important question about this.
Yeah.
I just need to see the video of his outfit.
I think it bothers
outfit.
Chris Carter more than me, but I get his point.
Do we have confirmation that before the game, that bird poop wasn't on his hat? Because maybe he added it afterwards because he was acknowledging that it was a bad game.
Oh, is that?
Looks like bird poop. So maybe he added that to the outfit because he was taking it seriously.
I don't know. You know way more about fashion than I do.
Well, that looks like bird poop. Also, that little flower looks like one of Nick's little flowers that he wears.
Listen, you could tell viscerally it bothered Chris Carter. But Chris Carter said what another great player said to me over the weekend, which was, man, what are we into? Like, what are we into here? Just thoughts.